Did I break the motor? The...
This is my first attempt to design my very own 3D printed remote controlled boat. It should be easy to print most of it in a single part, quick to assemble using a very cheap brushless motor. The hull is not completely flat at the bottom. It is a swamp catamaran hybrid. Right now, I will show you my first and only test drive, and after that, we will talk about 3D printing it.
Cameras. This one is running. This one is running too. No, this one. Is it running? Yeah, it is. All right. To see if it at least it floats a little bit. Oh my goodness. Let's give a little push. Now I got rid of the water. If it touches, it's not so maneuverable. It's so unstable.
Did I break the motor?
It's going down the water. Come! Come to me! Let's see what's happened.
Is this shaking noise?
Water. Do you want some milkshake?
Let's open. Oh yeah, the...
Okay.
It got a little bit of water. Just a little bit. But yes, see, let's see if it's hot. No, it's... Okay, it's warmy.
But it's okay. Maybe it got water and the circuit is confused. As you can see, cable management is a party here.
I need this to dry.
Okay.
Maybe it doesn't matter if it's dry or not.
All right. Do you guys like it?
Well, first try, come on.
Now the question is, does it have water inside? Oh, this works very nice.
No,
it's dry. So yeah, it only got water from here.
To be sure the prints were watertight, I began printing it in PETG on a Neptune 3 Plus. Super slow to fuse layers very well. Did it work? No. I still had to seal it with a spray varnish, and even then I still found imperfections. And I drilled two holes in the back to fully drain the water. The Neptune would take 2 days to print this, and I got impatient. So I also printed this one in PLA on the extremely fast FLSUN T1. It finished it in 13 hours. So when I got this printed, I had already finished the whole thing in here. A parenthesis, from the very beginning, I wanted to make the boat on the T1 in PETG, but I got layer shifts. Why? I don't know yet. I like the T1, it is unbelievably fast. In PLA, it was great. PETG, I tried 3 times. FLSUN is updating firmware almost every week, so fingers crossed. Printing the whole boat in a mostly a single part needs a tall printer that many people don't have, so I might split the hull in 2 parts so anyone can print it. I still need to design a better lid because adhesive, it's terrible, it sucks. Also, I made very little space for cable management between the hulls. It needs more space. I want a better way to seal the cables that go to the motor. The way I did, water splashes in and water comes in very easy. After I watched the recordings, I saw that the motor stopped working all at once after the propeller hit the water. I was convinced that the ESC got burned, but to my surprise, a few days later I tested it again. It was really water. It's dried and it's fine now. So this boat is not what I want yet. It was slow. I used a 2S battery and it will be faster with a 3S battery. But that would be a heavier battery and the boat right now barely floats. The full weight is 640 grams and half of it is plastic. Next time I will be more careful about the water displacement calculations in Fusion 360 and make a better hull. Also, making it run straight was impossible. It was very unstable. I think the boat needs to be a bit longer. I also want to try inverting the motor and bringing it closer to the center. I'm not even sure if making it a catamaran was actually good. Maybe a completely flat hull would be simpler and better. If you already made this type of boat before, by all means, advice would be very cool. The last time I played with remote control planes and boats, it was 30 years ago. Today I had so much fun. Thank you for being here. Would you like to print a boat yourself? Tell me in the comments if you want to see a better version of this boat and a complete tutorial to build one. And I'll see you soon here on Geek Detour.